Hey guys, and welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new, I'm DeannaaLee. Today, I have a video for you all about how to look stylish and cute and feel cute and stylish in the cold. So first things first, I wanted to talk about what I look for in a coat and jacket. And I just got this coat from Zara, so hopefully it is still available and I will link it down below for you. So whenever I'm trying on a coat in a store or if I ordered something and I'm trying it on at home, I always check to make sure that when I wear it open, it hits in a way where I can still show off my outfit. So I have some jackets that maybe I ordered online or I just inherited from someone and they kind of like just like swallow you up when you wear them. Instead of it just taking over your outfit, it adds to the outfit. So I love how this one sits when I just wear it like this. So like back in college and stuff, my friends and I would go out in the city in the winter and the stuff and take pictures. And I remember I would always, when it was cold out, I would always take my coat and throw it on the ground and then take pictures really cold in my cute outfit. And it's because all my coats were hiding my outfit and they weren't adding to the outfit. Look for what is actually going to make you feel cute and go with a lot of outfits. I like to follow kind of a two of everything rule. So I have a white coat that I love and I have a black coat that I love. And that way I always have one that's going to match an outfit. You also, of course, need to make sure it looks cute when it's closed. So always check. This one, not gonna lie, low-key giving bathrobe, but I like it. If you are petite like me, I do recommend if you want a longer coat, don't get one that is like a duster coat, like all the way to the floor, because it's just gonna make you look even tinier. I think having a little bit of ankle here is really helpful. Also, the pointed toe boot is a great way to look more stylish in the winter because it's a little more elegant. So this one is a pretty simple one. I wanted to start with something that was like very wearable. One of my biggest tips for this whole video is when you're styling an outfit for the cold, use contrast. In this case, oh, there's a squirrel outside.
Squirrel!
The biggest contrast that's happening is between the white and the black, obviously. So I have a monochrome black outfit happening, which always looks stylish on its own with the pointed toe. Again, it's very elevated. And then throwing a very contrasting coat. It could be like a light brown as well, like a camel colored coat. I don't have one of those. That would be really cute as well. And any coat with a hood gets bonus points. This hood is absolutely hooding. I said this in one of my shorts, but one thing that will always make any outfit look cuter is sunglasses on your head, purse on your side, and then gold jewelry. So I have my little necklace here, I have my ring stack, and I have some chunky gold earrings as well that are also making a statement. So all of those things together just really elevate the look. And I also have the little Celine belt on, which is another pop of gold to kind of tie it together. Oh, and the nails, of course. Another tip to look cute, have your nails done. I don't like wearing gloves, so I like to have my nails done in the winter because it's just, you look down and you feel put together. Okay, so here is the next look. I've been seeing this basic silhouette all over TikTok and Pinterest. I'm kind of calling it like the cozy clean girl. That's what it feels like to me. And what works really well about this outfit is, again, contrast. In this case, it's not color contrast, but it's the contrast of a very fuzzy knit sweater with a satin skirt. You could do this with satin trousers as well. I just think this looks so cute. It looks very quiet luxury when you pair those two together. It's actually a dress. So a little hack here, because I am petite, I didn't want to just leave the sweater all the way down because it would make me look super short and frumpy. So I have actually a belt on. I just threw on a little belt here and then I tucked the front of the sweater up into the belt as like a little French tuck moment. So it's still chunky and loose in the back here, but then in the front, it doesn't cut off my legs and make me look super tiny. I also have the platform UGG, of course, which is doing me plenty of favors in making me look taller. So platform boots, great choice for petite girlies. Again, we still have our statement rings and nails and my necklaces. I opted for my Versace dupe sunnies for a little elevated look. When it comes to staying warm in the winter, don't always just layer over. I actually have on a little top, like a little thermal white top underneath, and that is doing wonders to keep me super toasty. Even though the sweater is also warm, the two together make me so warm that I don't even feel the need to throw a coat on to go out in this in the cold. And then underneath, I have fleece-lined tights on. For this look, because it's so bright, I would opt for a nude fleece-lined tights, but mine just haven't come yet, so I'm wearing my black ones. And of course, you can also wear a chunky sock as well. You can even wear like just regular leggings underneath this, honestly. If I was even colder, I would throw a scarf on with this look. Cold tip, blanket scarves are amazing because, like the name implies, they can be worn as a scarf and they're super chunky and cute, but you can also wrap them around yourself and wear them as a blanket. I'll actually post the picture that this look was inspired by. This was inspired by a Pinterest outfit, so I will have that on screen for you to kind of see the inspiration. Now, another thing that makes this outfit look cute, even though it's super cozy, is that it's monochrome. I would call it almost chrome. Right, it's like almost monochrome. And I've been seeing this a lot for winter, is a lot of like creams and whites, like winter whites that almost match, but like not quite. So I feel like totally monochrome, all like bright white, would be like obnoxious to the eyes. So I have the bright white skirt, which makes it look a little more shiny and stuff. But then, you know, the sweater is more of a cream and this purse, more of like a chalk color. So we have different tones of white, implying monochrome, but it's almost chrome. Okay, so I mentioned you could do this look with satin trousers, so I wanted to try it out and see how it looked. These are my satin trousers. These are from Princess Polly, and it's just a little bit of a different look. However, I kept on my base layers. So I still have on my little thermal top, as well as my fleece lined tights. I actually do this a lot in the winter, especially when I'm wearing something that's baggier. Even though it's cozy, you know, air can get in your sleeves and in your pant legs. So wearing a thermal layer underneath is a great way to stay warm. This look is honestly like, I'm sweating right now. I would again wear this out without a coat and still feel cute and put together. I'm doing the same kind of French tuck moment. So I mentioned that I am a scarf person, and one of my tips is just to know your cold point. Right, so like everybody has an area that like bothers them when it's cold. I know I used to have a colleague who couldn't stand her hands being cold, so she would always have a good pair of gloves. For me, it's my neck. I can't stand when my neck or my feet are cold, so that's why I'm a big UGG lover, because they are honestly, some winters, they were the only shoe that would keep me warm in New York. So just kind of know your body and how it reacts to the cold. It's very helpful in informing how you dress. And once you know what you personally need to feel your warmest, again, I follow the two of everything rule. So for instance, the scarf that I mentioned, I have it in white and I have it in black. So I have one that can go with pretty much every outfit. Make sure you have two colors that will match the color palette of your wardrobe. Okay, this look, I really wanted to prove to you the power of base layers. So this is kind of a no pants trend look. I am wearing pants, I'm wearing shorts, but I am super toasty because again, I have my very warm sweater. One tip when picking out sweaters is just pick out materials that are actually going to keep you warm. So obviously wool and cashmere will keep you very warm. Honestly, polyester is a very warm material. Some people find it to be too warm, even though it's plastic. Like, and if you can't afford a wool sweater, don't turn away from polyester right away, because it will actually keep you very warm. This sweater is from H&M, but when I was going through H&M, like, there were so many sweaters where I picked them up on the hanger and like I could see the hanger through them. Like, that's how thin they were. So you want to make sure that the knit is very tight so that there's no holes in the fabric, and you want to go for a material that is going to be comfortable on your skin and keep you warm. Yeah, so I still have on underneath my little thermal layers, these lined tights, and I added in a pair of leg warmers. I think leg warmers are a great way, obviously, to keep warm. It's in the name. They keep your legs warmer. Vintage leather, by the way, will keep you super warm. So this is honestly so comfy. It feels like I'm wearing like just a chunky sweatshirt, and I'm super cozy and nice and warm. And again, the things that are also elevating this look are my jewelry, my nails, my sunnies. Almost forgot to grab my purse, but remember, a purse will always make an outfit look cuter. Another tip for looking cute in the cold is having a variety of jackets. You want two coats or jackets that can go with so many outfits. They're so versatile, like the coat I showed earlier. And then you want a handful, maybe three, four tops. You don't need a lot of jackets that really make an outfit, right? They add a little something different rather than being a basic coat, something a little more special, like this leather bomber. Maybe it's a puffer jacket, maybe it's a teddy coat or an aviator jacket, something like that. You want a handful of jackets that just like bring something different, and that way you will never get bored. And just watch out for those things I said earlier. Check how it looks when it's open, check how it looks when it's closed, bonus points if it has a hood, all of those things. One time, I remember years ago, I bought a jacket and I wasn't sure about it. So on the drive home from the mall, I put the jacket on and I blasted my AC. It sounds crazy, but like I did that and I was like, okay, If I don't get cold on this drive home, this jacket is like worth the money I spent. And it was. So that's a little test you can do to make sure your jacket's gonna keep you warm. Okay, so this next outfit I posted on my Instagram and everybody loved it over there. So I wanted to feature it today because it's actually extremely warm. And the reason is because obviously this sweater is super chunky. It's a very warm material. This is from Forever 21, by the way, and don't sleep on Forever 21 with the sweaters, you guys. I have two of their sweaters in my closet that have lasted me 10 years. I'm not exaggerating. I've had them for a very long time and they look great. So I have confidence in this sweater, even though it is a super affordable sweater. Obviously, it's super cute. It's got this off-the-shoulder moment. And my tip for this outfit is to get creative with your layering. So to make this even warmer, I actually have a tube bodysuit that is layered underneath this so that, you know, if any wind or air is coming through this chunky sweater, I'm still a little protected and covered there. Again, the fleece line tights make a comeback, and I just got these shoes from Steve Madden, so I wanted to show them off. The skirt is from Fashion Pass. Don't forget, you can always use my code for Fashion Pass to get $50 off your first month of a membership if you like this skirt. And going along with choosing materials that will keep you warm, this skirt is actually wool, which I mentioned earlier is a very warm material. So even though it's a mini skirt, it's still doing a lot to keep me warm. Even your skirts or your blouses can be nice warm materials. So in this case, I would definitely opt for a scarf, and that will keep me nice and warm in my personal cold point, which is my neck. But I could also, if I want to be extra warm, earmuffs. So yeah, I think earmuffs just, there's something so adorable about them. These are actually, they're from UGG, and they actually are headphones. A little idea I had that I personally didn't like for my style, but you might like, tying bows onto your earmuffs. I'm seeing a lot of people tying bows onto their headphones, so I think it's not gonna be long before we see people tying them onto their earmuffs as well. I'm not even wearing a coat and I'm super toasty. One style rule that I've kind of been playing with lately is to try to go for unlikely pairings. For instance, in this outfit, I'm wearing this little cropped fur jacket, which is, it's faux fur, by the way, this little cropped faux fur jacket, which is something you would think of as a pretty elegant, maybe a nighttime piece, but I'm pairing it with some baggy jeans. So this is very Pinterest right now. I've been seeing this a lot around Pinterest. You wouldn't expect somebody to maybe pair this particular jacket with these jeans. And this outfit is, again, very warm. I actually still have the fleece line tights on underneath, so my jeans are even extra warmer than they are. Obviously, I have long sleeves on underneath this and a little scarf to help keep my neck warm. The pairing of these two just makes it look so effortlessly cool. And of course, I feel like the nails and the rings are doing a lot for this outfit in particular. And I feel like this one needs sunglasses. Like, it's just giving Pinterest girl. So that is the power of having some variety in the jackets that you wear. So to prove that to you, I'm gonna take this pretty plain outfit and throw on a few different jackets to show you how they change the vibe. Okay, so obviously the beloved leather bomber makes an appearance and the vibe has shifted. So having a variety of jackets lets me feel warm and comfortable, but in different ways, expressing myself differently with my outerwear. Throwing on a little puffer. Now the outfit feels a little more casual, and again, we have an unlikely pairing because we have the black and brown, which we wouldn't really normally reach for. And it's just giving a little bit more of a sporty look, a little simpler, a little more casual. Again, variety of jackets gives you a lot of options. It sounds really straightforward, but you don't need to spend a lot of money on jackets. Most of my jackets and coats are from Savers, and most of them were under $20. So I strongly recommend Savers. If you don't have a Savers near you, I love Depop. I actually saw recently an Abercrombie coat on there for $50, which probably retailed for like $250. So you can save a lot of money by buying your coats secondhand. Here's my other coat. Remember I mentioned I like to always kind of have two of each. Again, it lays open very nicely, but then when I tie it closed, still very flattering. And this is a coat that I thrifted from Savers for much less than I would have paid for it if I bought it outright. I also need to touch up my lip oil here. One thing that always helps me feel cute in the cold too is also having my makeup done and feeling confident about my makeup. So doing what makes me feel confident. For my hair in the winter, I really do wear it up pretty much all the time, because if I don't, scarves and coats and things like that will tangle it. I also feel like The winter can be very windy, so for hair health purposes, I do recommend you find a nice updo that you can kind of throw in every day, whether it's like a little messy ponytail, claw clip situation like I have now, or maybe it's like a slick back bun, just something to kind of protect your hair a little bit from the harsh winters. So here is this look with the coat and the jeans and the pointed shoe. Again, this look, it was a very simple base, but all of these jackets gave me a totally different option of how I can show up. So I want to kind of recap quickly all of the little tips because I know I kind of just spewed them out at you. The first one, of course, was my tips on how to pick a coat that will look cute in any outfit. A second tip, just having a variety of fun jackets, maybe a handful of different jackets that add a statement to an outfit. Next tip was, of course, my jewelry. I feel like every time I look down at my hands with these rings, I feel so much cooler than I actually am. And the nails help with that as well. And having your makeup and your hair done in an intentional way, even if it's something simple, will help you feel more put together. Find ways to incorporate contrast into your outfits. I mentioned also the unlikely pairings. So go for the unlikely pairings, like the little fur jacket over a casual outfit. I feel like even over some like flared leggings might look cute. My other tip, of course, sunglasses and a purse make every outfit cuter. I swear, I don't know how, but they just do. Again, I followed the two of everything approach with all my accessories, so I have sunglasses that match every outfit and purses that match every outfit. Knowing your cold point, knowing which area of your body irritates you the most when it's cold, and then adjusting accordingly for that. Get creative with your layering. That was my other tip. So don't forget that you don't only have to layer over your clothes, but you can layer under your clothes. Invest in some good base layers. This brings me to my final few tips. My final tip, help your body adjust. I know it's kind of hard nowadays because the temperature has been kind of all over the place, but the biggest thing that helps me personally living in New York and staying warm in the winter is that I like to take morning walks. They're very good for your mental health. I highly recommend them for a lot of reasons, but another reason I recommend them is because they actually help me adjust to the cold winter. So as soon as it starts getting chilly out, when I take my 10-minute morning walk, I force myself to go out less dressed than I want to be. So basically, like, if I want to throw a coat on because, like, you know, we just came off of summer and it's warm and it's now 40 degrees and I'm cold, I don't let myself put a coat on. I put a light jacket on or I put a sweatshirt on and I walk like that. I don't pile it on right away as soon as it gets cold, because if you do that, your body doesn't adjust to the cold as seamlessly. The winter just stops bothering me. It doesn't bother me nearly as much as it would if, and as it does in like winters when I don't do that. So that is a big thing that has helped me. Okay, so I know this video was a little chaotic, but I hope you found all my little tips helpful. Let me know if you want to see more outfits like this, more cold weather outfits. I am also starting to do a cold weather outfit series over on TikTok and Instagram. So if you want more outfits that will keep you warm in the cold weather, be sure to follow me there. I will have my handles for both on the screen here. As always, you can shop anything that I link down below. I'll make sure to link anything I can. And that is everything, you guys. Let me know what kind of videos you want to see next, and I will see you in the next Fashion Friday. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.